Hi, I'm George Pearson, and in this video, we'll be doing this Photoshop blueprint effect. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit that like button and share. You can support this channel through Patreon, and don't forget to subscribe. I do several videos a week. Here's my current schedule. Weekends are kind of flexible, and I also may be putting in other videos in the off days as well. Take a look at my complete training for Photoshop. Also, there's a link for that right down there in the description. And let's go ahead and get to it. For this Photoshop blueprint effect, what you need is a black and white line drawing. And we'll get ours from a previous video I did where I made this blue line effect based upon a photograph. Now, if you want to see how this one was done, there's a link for that up there in the upper right-hand corner and also in the description. And this will work either with a blue line image like this or even with just a straight black and white image like that. I'll show you both versions of this. Let's do the blue line first. And for this one, we need to copy the whole thing. Let's go up here to Select and All right there. And then Edit, Copy Merged. Now Merge copies all of these layers onto one new layer, so copy merged. Let's now make a new file, File New. Since we have that one copied, it'll be sitting on the clipboard, so we can use clipboard as our new file size, choose Create, and then Edit Paste will fit exactly. And there it is, there's our blue line effect. Okay, let's go back here again, and I'm going to turn off those layers right there and just leave just this basic drawing without the outline or anything. Now this black and white image is just on one layer, so just a regular copy will work. Edit, copy, go back to our new file, and edit, paste. So there we go, there's our black and white line drawing and our blue line drawing. We'll do it from both of those. They'll both work out just fine. Okay, we can now close this one down. We're done with this. There we go, and I won't bother saving that. And we also don't need this up any longer. I'll close that one down as well. Okay, we'll start with the blue line effect right here. Our next step is to put in the blue for the background for our blueprint effect. So I'll come down to the background layer right here, go up to Layer and do a new fill layer, solid color. Just choose OK right there. And then down here, type in 0000 6D. There it is, 00006D. Choose OK. If I hide that blue line, there's our nice blue background. And the reason why I wanted this in as a fill layer, instead of just filling a regular layer with a paint bucket, is with a fill layer I can double click on this icon here and then easily change my coloration. So it makes it very, very easy in here. Okay, let's bring our blue line back up again. Now to make this appear as if it is line drawing on here, we need to have this inverted, and we also need to have this as a grayscale. So of course our grayscale is already set for that. That one's fine. Let's go ahead and work on this one. So we're going to first convert this to a black and white image. So it's Image, Adjustments, Black and White. There we go. Now I like a bit more contrast for this, so this was all in blues. So come down here to the blue layer and just move that to the left until you have a nice contrast, something like kind of like that. Nice heavy contrast in here is pretty good. Choose OK. There's our black and white version. Now on the regular black and white up here, it's not contrasty enough. Let's go ahead and punch the contrast up on this layer. So if you're working with the blue line, you can do your contrast as you're doing your conversion to black and white. If you're working with just a black and white image, you may want to boost the contrast. It's up to you. Let's go ahead and do that as well. Adjustments and Levels, and just bring the black side up right there until you get a nice bit of contrast in there. Those become our white lines. Okay, at that point these are basically the same thing except for that outline right there. We'll come back to that in just a bit. So this is our blue line layer. I'm going to make a change here. Let's just rename this one blue line, and grayscale. Okay, on the blue line one, we're going to invert this so it's a negative of this. Image, Adjustments, and Invert. There it is. Same thing on the grayscale one. The exact same step. Image, Adjustments, and Invert. Now, to get these looking like they're drawn onto that blue background, all you have to do is change the blend mode up here to Linear Dodge Add, and there it is. At this point, you can adjust the brightness just by adjusting the opacity level over here. Seeing a little less opacity, more opacity, whatever you want. I'm going to leave this all the way to the top just for this video so it's easy to see. But when you're doing your own version, you can adjust the brightness right down in here. Okay, so we did that one. Let's do the same thing for our grayscale version. Just change the blend mode to Linear Dodge Add, and there it is. Okay, so far so good. Let's go back and work on this one. The next thing we need is our grid lines in here. Now, I've seen other ways of doing this where there's some complicated stuff, very, very tricky and interesting on making a nice, neat pattern that will create a grid for you. Clever stuff, but we don't need that. Let me show you how this is done. Go to the top up here, make a new layer. There it is. Go up to your paint bucket. Change this to pattern, open your patterns up, and you'll find right there, there's a grid pattern. Click on that, and then just fill this, and there's your grid. No need to do anything fancier than that. It's already included inside of Photoshop, so we have our grid all set to go. Now, obviously, it's the wrong color, so let's invert this one. Same steps as we did with our house images. So, image, adjustments, invert, and then mode, Linear Dodge Add. Now it comes in too bright, so let's tone this down by bringing the opacity down to 50. I'll just type that in. 50%, there it is. Now notice that the size of the image out here is a bit too large because of that line in there. So we're going to ignore that line, and we'll make a new line just inside this a little bit, and I'll show you how that's done in just a second. But first we want to do a layer mask and mask out the grid out here on the grid line. So we're on our grid, so it says layer one. We're going to grab the rectangular marquee tool up here and come in two and two on the grid right there, and then just pull the marquee down and come down to two and two, two squares in, two squares down, or up rather, just right about there. And let go. There's your selection. Hit the layer mask button. There's a layer mask, and that now blocks that grid out. Now that we have that layer mask done, we can copy that layer mask down to these two layers. Let's just bring this one in. Hold the Alt key down, grab the layer mask, and pull it straight down. Do the same thing one more time for the blue line. There we go. So we just now copy that down. So we now have this shown. Now all we need is that nice light outline again, and we can make that one right on our top grid up here because we have that same outline. So let's open up the layer styles. Layer style. Of course, you can also use the button in the bottom right hand corner down there, but it's easier to see up here what I'm doing. Come down to stroke, and we want to have this set at inside. And you can see there's the stroke right there. That's at 2 pixels. We can go a little bit more, 3 pixels. Kind of nice, just large enough so it looks good. And color is white. And choose OK. So there's your nice outline. You can adjust the pixel size on that to make it brighter if you want to, brighter or thicker. That again is 3 pixels. And that works with either of our two images. There's the one. There's the other one. This is from the grayscale. That's from our blue line. Okay, at that point, it's all done, except for putting in our legend right up here. If you want to do a legend, then you'll need to download a nice architecture font for that. Let me bring that up and show you where I found that architecture font. There we go. It's called Architect's Draft, and I found this on defont.com, and there's the link. I'll put this link on my video download page for this video so you can go ahead and find that very easy. Or just go to Defont and look for Architect's Draft. Same thing. Once you're on this page, it's 100% free, as you can see right there, but it's not a bad idea to donate something to the author for this nice bit of work on this really nice font. Click this download button. Don't click anything else. Just go for that download button right there, right below where it says 100% free. That's the one that you want. This will download as a zip file. Let me just go down here. And inside of the zip file, you'll have these files. We'll be using the Architect's Draft Bold. You can install this either as a true type or as an open type font, either one depending upon what you need. If you're inside Windows, just double click on the font, brings this up, and you can install right there. Now to install this font, you'll have to first close down Photoshop, then install the font, and then reopen Photoshop. The reason for that is because Photoshop reads the font list when it opens up. So if you don't close down Photoshop first, you won't see this inside your font list, but you'll see it once you close down and reopen Photoshop. It will then show up. Of course, I already have mine installed, so we're all set to go on that step. So we need a little box right up in here. For that, I'll just grab the shape tool right here. I'll be using the rectangle tool. I have it set with a fill of nothing and with a stroke right here of white. So it's white stroke. And 2 pixels is a little bit thin up here. We can go to 3. 3 matches this line right there. There we go. And then come over here. I'm going to come over here a little ways. And let's just do this about 4 boxes down and go over a little bit. Once you have this done, you can position it where you want to. There we go. There's the line. That's a bit too thick, I think, on this. A bit bright. I'm going to tone that down to 2 pixels. A little better. I think that's okay. It's still too bright. We can tone that down over here on the opacity. I just want it to match the outline. Now the outline is going to be at 50% because the grid is at 50%. So there we go. Now once you have this, you can put this anywhere you want. You can put it right into the corner like that. That's one look. Or you can indent it a little ways. That's another look. It depends on you whether you want it right up against the edge or if you want it indented a little bit. Let's go ahead and just do this one right on the edge. And grab the wrong thing there. Let me just do one thing here. Move tool and undo auto select right there. That way we won't have that problem again. And I'll put that right in the corner, right there. Take a little nudging with the cursor keys, the arrow keys, get exactly right, and that's it. Okay, now we have our box in place. We can go ahead over to the type tool. Make sure you have white as your foreground color. And then on the text, we're going to be using 2 text sizes, one for the top line, and then a different size for the second line. For our top line, let's use 12 point. And again, the typeface over here is that Architect's Bold. There's the line. This has come down a little bit so I can find that one. Architect's Draft Bold right there. Okay, come in here someplace. Now, notice when I come in here, I get that kind of a cursor with a circle around it. I don't want to be using that. That's going to be putting text inside of a shape, which is not what I want to be doing. So to prevent that from happening, let's put a new layer above that rectangle layer. Now I have the regular cursor. Just come in here someplace like this and then type in our heading right there, Modern House 1. That's pretty good. And then come back into our text, do an enter. Let's change our type size here to 8. And I'll put my name right there. Now I want this as a separate line from the rectangle so I can change it easily or move it around like this with my cursor keys and get it positioned just where I want it. And there we go. There's your nice blueprint effect. And again, we can adjust the value in here of your grid easily by just adjusting the opacity of the grid. We can adjust the brightness of the drawing. Just come down to your drawing layer, and that's right there. It says opacity. You can adjust that in here. So there we go. That's how to do this blueprint effect here inside of Photoshop.